After studying this module, you shall be able to know about history of yoga meditation, learn about their definition and various types, identify scientific nature of yoga, evaluate the true human nature by yoga and meditation, analyze yoga psychotherapy. Introduction. Yoga is a physiological, psychological and spiritual activity which has the ultimate goal to unite mind, body and soul along with a state of unity with the environment one is placed in. It is being practiced from over 400 years and nowadays is used by people to stay fit both mentally and physically. Meditation can be defined as an activity in which the mind is trained in a specific way and an alternate state of consciousness is tried to achieve. Some practitioners of meditation defined it as the deepest sleep when the mind becomes free from the negative emotions of hate, resentment, and agitation, and in turn is filled with the positive emotions of love, joy, serenity, and high spiritual experience. Now we'll have a look at the brief history of yoga and meditation. The yoga originally had its birth in India around 5,000 years ago. Its origin resides long time back at the time of Harappan civilization. Excavations have found seals which had images of yogis. Harappa and Mohenjo-daro were one of the most important cities of that time who were being credited for the formation of Hinduism, Jainism, Buddhism along with the other Harappan cities. Most yoga writings are being found in Sanskrit language. This principle of the focus of the mind lies at the core of the modern day yoga. Around 200 AD, the pre-classical yoga emerged with the text of the Upanishads. Hoodie talked about the unity of everything. Around 500 AD, classical yoga was formed, which was versed at the Yoga Sutra of Patanjali. It is often called as Raj Yoga. It has 8 different forms. It emphasized that every being is composed of Purusha and Prakriti. Yoga being the method to differentiate between these both and purify the Purusha or soul of the person. Post-classical yoga is comprised of the series of various schools that develop their own kind of techniques. Vedanta, which seeks the ultimate unity of everything, developed on the basics of Upanishads. Alchemy led to the development of Tantra Yoga, with Hatha Yoga as one of its branch, which focused on energizing one's body to an extent that its basic element gets changed, prolonging one's life or even claim to make one immortal. Swami Vivekanand, Indra Devi, Swami Shivananda and many more yogis are being credited for the emergence and practice of yoga in the West. Defining yoga. The word yoga emerged from the Sanskrit root yuj, which means to join or to yoke. Thus, it can be understood as a connection, unity, oneness, integration, accord, cohesion or harmony between one's body, mind and soul. The continued practice of yoga will lead one to a sense of peace and well-being and also a feeling of being at one with his environment. Panini, a Sanskrit grammarian, proposed that the word yoga has two roots, yujir yoga, which means combining, and yuj samadhi, which means concentrating. Patanjali, who developed yoga sutras, claimed that yuj samadhi as the real meaning of the word yoga, while Bhagavad Gita supports yujir yoga as the root of word yoga. Yoga seeks to reduce the materialism which exerts pressure on the human soul and to use method of introspection in order to attain stillness in the fast-pacing world. Hence, practicing yoga can be explained as a continuum of the unbreakable postures that purports to achieve the ultimate calmness, peacefulness, and equilibrium of the spirit. Some have defined it as an internal projection from the world havoc and upheavals. Patanjali proposed that daily practicing yoga can break those habits, thoughts and actions which represent corruption, negativity and materialism in a person. Broadly, it can be defined as a composite system of spiritual disciplines which are basic to Hinduism, Jainism and Buddhism that were formed early in Asia. Yoga and its types. There are various types of yoga that are developed over time across the world. Some of them are discussed below, which are Hatha Yoga, one of the most popular type of yoga in the West to deal with the stress, anxiety and depression. It includes position of the body, which means asanas, regulation of breathing, that is pranayam, and focusing on the concentration, that is dhyan. Next we have Bikram yoga, this type which involves intense workout. It aims to increase one's persistence, muscle strength, pliability, and to achieve an optimum weight. Ishta, the integral science of Hatha and Tantric arts which seek to unblock the energy channels via poses of the body, concentration and imagination. Then we have Integral Yoga. It involves poses of the body, control of one's breath, servicing selflessly, meditating, chanting, praying and exploring oneself. Then we have Ashtanga Yoga. It is a type of yoga which requires high physical labor. Ashtanga yoga requires one to control breath along with the formation of progressive incessant chain of the body postures. Jiva Mukti yoga. Jiva Mukti yoga is the type of yoga which affects the spirit of its practitioners due to its emphasis on reading scriptures, praying and being non-violent and vegetarian along with the physical activity. Kripalu yoga. It is a yoga type which emphasizes on being in a body posture for a while until it gets changed by itself. Thus, it focuses on the consciousness of the person. Kundalini. Kundalini emphasizes on the arousing of the energy at the spine's base and gradually dissipates into the other parts of the body. Restorative yoga. It's a type of yoga used principally for relaxation of muscles. The person lies down on carpet, rug, pillow, block, etc. for a long stretch of time in a passive manner. Lyinga yoga. The slower version of yoga which uses materials like pillows, carpets, belts, etc. in order to make it comfortable for the injured, physically disabled or old age people. Now we must also understand the scientific nature of yoga. Yoga can be viewed as a science which seeks to help one to systematically explore its own self in a process of self-realization and creating a harmony between the spirit and the body. It involves systematic technique of meditation, controlling of breathing pattern and a chain of series of bodily postures. The ultimate goal is to help the human practicing it in one way or another, just same as that of science. Exploring the true human nature through yoga. The word yoga literally means to unite or to combine ourselves with our true nature. This integration can only be done via following various yoga principles. Before this integration, we are insecure, fearful, separate from ourselves, doubtful, and more or less incomplete. The only relation that self has is from itself. Thus, yoga helps a person to have an insight of itself, which is clear, endless, and infinite. According to the Patanjali, there are five prerequisites which decide the person's psychological condition or chitta vritti, avidya, or disregard, asmita, or one's personal identity, raga, or enthusiasm, dvesha, or rage, and abhinivesha, or desire to be alive. These entire five states join together to form psychological condition of a person. But they are, as a rule, responsible for all the sufferings of human. Thus, human life is a suffering. Then we must also understand what is meditation. Meditation going till the infinity. So how do we define meditation? Meditation can be defined as a method in which a person teaches his mind to enter into a specific state of consciousness. Meditation refers to the chain of strategies that involve a deliberate attempt to concentrate one's attention in a non-judgmental ways to achieve a stillness of mind and thoughts and to avoid vague and deep forms of thinking. So meditation basically has four components. First, meditation includes the purpose to concentrate on a specific object, state or whatever it requires. Secondly, meditation does not require to be necessarily be defined with reference to a religious activity. Thus, practicing meditation may involve continuously reiterating a specific word or a paragraph, but with the aim to achieve oneness, peacefulness and stillness, and not with the aim to please God through praying. Thirdly, it is also inclusive of a deliberate effort to control the mind from wandering here and there and to maintain a continuous focus on the practice. There are different instructions in order to face such a situation. Fourthly, it is not significant that what is the thought. It just may appear and disappear. What is important is the conscious attention of the continuum of the appearing and disappearing of thoughts. Hence, initially meditation may had originated as a religious activity, but gradually it turned as a means of attaining calmness, tranquility, serenity, stillness, along with the aim to build an inner energy filled with warmth, kindness, and with a forgiving, generous, and patient nature. Meditation and its types. There are various types of meditational practices that have emerged over a period of time. However, here we will describe some of them. First one is transcendental meditation. It's a concentrative type of meditation which involves sitting rigid in a straight posture and repeatedly chanting a holy word like Om. Main focus is to achieve stillness along with the control and manipulation of the breathing process. The distraction by the alternative thoughts is prevented by activity, first noticing the thought, then returning back to the practice. Transcendental meditation may lead to the feeling of exclusion of spirit from physical body, which ultimately leads to the construction of new form of energy. Its origin lies in the Vedanta school of meditation of Hinduism. Then we have Vipassana meditation, also known as mindfulness form of meditation, which has its origin lying in Buddhism. It involves getting aware of each and every thought that appears in the consciousness with being detached and non-judgmental. It is preferably a process of observation of the breathing process, present senses, emotions, sounds, or images. The practice being implicated in the routine activities like eating, working, drinking, etc. It can be termed as a form of low energy. Vipassana meditation is one of the most famous forms of meditation. Then we have Zazen meditation. This is one of the most difficult form of meditation, having its origin in Buddhism. It involves sitting in a straight posture and paying minimal or least attention to any activity. It starts with focusing one's attention to an immediate underlying thought, turning it then to another level of consciousness, the pre-conscious mind. Requiring higher concentration, it is thereby directed to the final level of consciousness, that is the unconscious mind. Some have argued that unconscious is not the final level, but the concentration reaches to another level of pure consciousness. The ultimate aim of Zazen is to combine and to achieve openness in all levels of consciousness. Kundalini meditation. It is a branch of meditation that has its origin lying in the Vedanta school of meditation. It focuses on the flow of energy from the bottom of the spine toward the head, passing by the various energy centers of the body. The breathing process is controlled in order to produce a continuum of energy and to take it to the infinity. However, a major drawback of this type is that if practiced inappropriately, it may lead to a psychological disorder named Kundalini syndrome. Next type of meditation we have is Qigong meditation. This is a form of meditation which was first encouraged by Taoism. The energy is rotated in the body via various energy centers and organ systems in a circle called the microcosmic orbit, principally by the process of controlling and manipulating one's breathing processes. The awareness is concentrated on three parts of the body: navel, chest, and head. Yoga and meditation having their dark faces. Despite having been very, very effective in improving the life of human beings, both the practices also have some limitations or the drawbacks, which may result in severe consequences if not practiced under supervision. Their adverse effects can be both physical and psychological. Most of the supporters argue that these problems arise only if yoga meditation is performed inappropriately or out of the recommended sequence. Others propose that when these activities are performed without any religious context or without any appropriate supervision, it can lead to dysfunctional problems. Moreover, performing them more than the required amount, that is over practice, may lead to adversity. Being overambitious, competitive, and going beyond one's limits can also cause problems. Yoshikawa proposed 7 factors to consider while performing yoga postures that require one to get upside down. which may include Sarvangasana or Shirsasana. Uneasiness. Uneasiness may indicate overstraining on head area, which should be avoided by slowly returning back to the normal position. Spinal spondylosis. Any undue pressure on the vertebral column should be avoided in order to avoid injury. Heart problems and blood pressure. Inversion directs high blood pressure towards head, so over practicing should be avoided. People with a cardiovascular disorder should also take preliminary precautions and expert supervision. Diabetes. People with diabetes always have some amount of heart problems, which requires them to look for cautionary measures. Ablepsia. Without prior practice, a sudden inversion may lead to the bursting of retinal veins of eyes. Sinus or ear infections. A precautionary measure for people with infections or inflammations in the head region. Pregnancy. Being upside down can result in complications in pregnancy, particularly after the first 3 months of pregnancy. In mentally disordered patients, meditation may elicit certain feelings, thoughts, images, temporary weakness, and depersonalization that may add up to their mental imbalance. So, despite a number of adverse effects produced by the meditation and yoga, they are being largely emphasized by many of the practitioners and supporters, possibly because their merits outnumber their demerits, because of mental peace and oneness they provide us within today's fast-paced technological world. Principles of yoga and meditation apply to psychotherapy. Psychotherapy refers to assisting the patient to deal with the maladjustment, behavioral and mental problems via psychological professional, clinical psychologist or psychiatrist, with the goal to change the patient's problematic emotions, ideas, beliefs or responses. Here we will explain the use of meditation and yoga in a psychotherapeutic technique, which are largely studied by the field yoga psychotherapy. What is yoga psychotherapy? The origin of yoga psychotherapy is in Vedanta, a school of monistic Indian philosophy, which emphasizes on the point that every person has a pure consciousness, and it is this consciousness which never changes in a person, as opposed to our feelings, ideas, values, and physical body that do continually fluctuate with time. Yoga psychotherapy does not only seeks to enhance a person at this personality level, rather it seeks to do it at a very higher level of acceptance of ourselves and the reality, happiness and peace. It seeks to provide the person with a sense of personal freedom and acceptance of the reality of himself or of his environment, and maintain balance with it in order to grow, evolve, to achieve goals, values and stability of emotions, liberate inner energy and potential for action. Now we'll discuss the principles of yoga therapy, which are as follows. Number one, yoga psychotherapy is empirical by nature, that is, it initially deals with only certain issues and problems of the client and then end them into psychotherapy. Number two, yoga psychotherapy not only aims to reduce the hardship of the person, but also to induce in him such powerful positive emotions of love, hope, joy, innovation and faith. Number three, yoga psychotherapy is an approach of the whole, that is, to seek to merge the cognition, behaviors, emotions, experiences, physiology and interpersonal and spiritual aspects of the person. Number four, by operation, yoga psychotherapy is experiential and experimental and has two aims. First, to provide the client with the freedom of personal choice and right to decide. Secondly, the methods of experiments applied help the psychotherapist to decide the type of method and conditions best suited for the client. Number five, yoga psychotherapy has a spiritual essence in the sense that it provides its clients with the ideas and methods which can be used by him over his entire life. Yoga psychotherapy is the only kind of psychotherapy which focuses on the client's spirit. It provides its clients with the polar attitudes and emotions like good or bad, anger or peace, hate or love, etc. It helps the clients in the process of acceptance of self-actualization. Yoga psychotherapy is a culture-free technique. Its methods and beliefs can be applied to the people of almost any culture or religion, no matter whether they are the followers of Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, Sufism, or any other.